In this video, I'll be discussing empirical and molecular formulas. Our objective is to explain the difference between empirical and molecular formulas of molecular compounds. Hopefully you remember that compounds can be classified as either molecular or ionic. Molecular compounds are composed of only nonmetals, whereas ionic compounds are composed of metals and nonmetals. There are different ways to express the formulas for molecular compounds. One way is through the empirical formula, which is the lowest whole number ratio of atoms in that compound. Another way to express the formula of these compounds is by using the molecular formula, which is the actual composition of the compound. In other words, how many atoms of each type are actually found in that molecule. If the molecular formula is already the smallest whole number ratio of atoms within the compound, it's the same as the molecular formula. Let's take this molecule, for example. If you inspect these different representations of this molecule, you'll notice the molecular formula, meaning the actual number of atoms in the compound, includes 6 carbons and 6 hydrogens. This gives a molecular formula of C6H6. This is not the same as the empirical formula in this case because it can be reduced. In other words, we can divide the number of carbons and the number of hydrogens both by a common value, 6. In doing this, we obtain the empirical formula of CH. What are some other possible molecular formulas with the empirical formula CH? Well, we can determine that by multiplying CH by 2, C2H2, or by 3, C3H3, or 4, C4H4, on and on. These are all potential molecular formulas that correspond with the same empirical formula. Let's look at a different example. Let's consider the empirical formula CH2O, which represents 1 carbon, 2 hydrogens, and 1 oxygen. If we multiply this by 1, which seems like a little bit of a silly exercise, but bear with me, we'll get the same formula, CH2O, 1 carbon, 2 hydrogens, and 1 oxygen. This corresponds to formaldehyde, the molecule shown here. This is one example where the molecular formula of formaldehyde, CH2O, is the same as the empirical formula because it can't be further reduced. It's already the lowest whole number ratio of atoms. We can also multiply this empirical formula by 2, giving us the molecular formula C2H4O2. This corresponds to acetic acid, as shown by these molecules, models rather. Another option is to multiply by 3, giving us the molecular formula C3H6O3. This molecule is represented by these models shown here. These are 3 different molecular formulas, meaning 3 different compositions of atoms within the molecule, but they share the same empirical formula, which in all cases here is CH2O. An important consideration that might be helpful when thinking about the relationship between the empirical and molecular formula is to consider their molar masses. You should be able to calculate the molar mass of CH2O as 30 grams per mole. Let's consider the molar masses of our various molecular formulas. The molar mass of CH2O, which is multiplying the empirical formula by 1, is 30 grams per mole. The molar mass of C2H4O2, multiplying the molar mass of the empirical formula by 2, gives us 60 grams per mole. And lastly, multiplying the molar mass by 3 gives us the corresponding molar mass of C3H6O3, which is 90 grams per mole. In this video, I've introduced the difference between the empirical and molecular formulas for molecular compounds. Here are some practice problems that you can do on your own to strengthen your understanding of this objective. Good luck, and I'll see you in the next video.